हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास नाइन्थ, नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द स्टोरी. यू मस्ट नो दैट स्टोरी नंबर वन फ्रॉम दिस बुक ट्रेजर ट्रव ऑफ शॉर्ट स्टोरी, अ कलेक्शन ऑफ एसएससी पोएम एंड शॉर्ट स्टोरी. चैप्टर नंबर वन हियर चैप्टर नंबर वन यू सी Chief Seattle's speech has been reduced from your course. Chief Seattle's speech has been reduced from your course this year. So you will study this time the story number two, The Old Man at the Bridge by Ernest Hemingway. Let us start. Old Man at the Bridge by Ernest Hemingway. First of all, you must know the outline about the story, and then from tomorrow I will read here paragraph wise, then you will understand it properly. First of all, very seriously, attentively, by paying with full attention, you please listen about the story Old Man at the Bridge. The story Old Man at the Bridge is related to a soldier and an old man. This is a conversation between a soldier and an old man. There are two characters mainly, a soldier and an old man whose age is 76 years. Conversation between a soldier and an old man who had to leave his hometown during the Spanish Civil War. During the war, there was panic and anxiety all around. Everywhere there was chaos, disorder. Everyone was aware of the impending death. An old man with spectacles who had walked 12 kilometers from his hometown sat exhausted by the side of a road near a pontoon bridge that crossed a river. Carts, trucks, and men, women, and children were crossing the bridge. Peasants, refugees, and Republican soldiers laden with munitions and supplies fled the advancing fascist army. The narrator, who said that his mission was to cross the bridge and find out how far the enemy had advanced, did so. He saw the old man sitting beside the bridge when he crossed towards the enemy. He found him still sitting there when he crossed back. He began talking to the old man and came to know that his hometown was San Carlos. He was the last person to leave the town, as he was anxious about his animal. He was only worried about his animals that he had. The narrator, who was nervously awaiting the advent of the fascist army and the ensuing battle between the armies, asked the old man about his animals. The old man said that he had charge of 2 goats, a cat, and 4 pairs of pigeons. He said that a captain had told him to leave the town and the animals because of artillery fire. He also told the narrator that he had no family. He then expressed concern about what would happen to the animals. He said that the cat would be all right, because cats could look after themselves, but he did not know what would happen to the other animals. The narrator, who was more concerned for the old man's safety than those of the animals, inquired what the old man's politics was. The old man replied that he had none. He told the narrator that he was an old man of 76 and had come 12 kilometers and was too tired to go further. The narrator told him to walk up the road and catch a ride on a truck to Barcelona. The old man thanked him but continued to express his concern over the fate of the animals he had left behind. The narrator reassured him, saying the animals would be fine. The narrator told him that the pigeons would fly away, but the old man continued to worry about the goats. The narrator told him that it was better not to think about them and that he should get up and walk to the trucks and leave that place. He thanked the narrator and got to his feet, swayed from side to side, and then sat down backwards in the dust. He reflected his obsession about the fate of the animals when he remarked that he was only taking care of animals. The narrator felt pity for the old man and remarked that there was nothing to do about him. He thought that the old man's only luck was that cats could look after themselves and that the day was overcast, so the fascists were unable to launch their planes. Here, students, you must know where the story was set. The story, the setting of the story, where the story was set, you must know. The story is set near the pontoon bridge. A pontoon bridge. In the countryside of the Ebro Delta during war. The enemy attack can commence any time. The narrator, also a soldier, goes across the bridge to find out how far the enemy had progressed. He is watchful and is a little tense. All kinds of people Men, women and children and cars and trucks were moving fast to save their lives. An old man sat near the pontoon bridge without stirring. The narrator sees him and engages him in a conversation. This takes the story forward. While he is concerned about the old man's safety, the old man was worried about only his animals. There is an atmosphere of uncertainty and danger. This was all about the story. You will study this story tomorrow in detail. Thank you so much.